Good morning students, good morning to all. Last day we have studied about something, the effect on distributions. So the effect of inflation on the distributions, how the inflations are affecting the distribution side, and in this distribution side those who all will be affected by the inflations and those who all will be get the benefit of the inflations. Okay, just 5 minutes we will remind about the effects on the distribution. After that we will go to the next concept. Okay, and in the time of inflation, the debtors and the creditors, so that during the inflation time the debtors will be as a gainers and the creditors will be as a losses, because it is functioning on the basis of the value of money. When the time of inflation, so the value of money may be decreased and the volume of money will be very highest and the availability of money also will be very more. Okay, but in the time, so the debtors will be able to give back to the money from the creditors, but the creditors can able to buy the money from the debtors, but even he will not be able to having the more purchasing power, because the value of money is very low and the purchasing power also will be very low, because prices of commodity will be higher. Okay, so the inflation time, so the debtor will be as a gainer and the creditor will be as a losses. It is the basis on the value of money and the purchasing power of money. Okay, so even if the creditors give back the money from the debtors, he cannot able to purchasing more commodities, but in the same time debtors easily give back the money to the creditors. Okay, so the debtors will be as a gainers. Next, fixed income groups. The fixed income groups are the worst hit during the inflations, because in this fixed income group will have the same amount of the income, but in the same time, so the prices of the commodities may be at higher. Okay, but normally if they have the 1,000 rupees income per individual persons and they are able to purchasing some amount of commodities, suddenly if the inflation situations is arised and the prices are going very high, means so the fixed income groups will not able to purchasing more commodities, because their income is not increased on the basis of increasing the inflation, increasing the prices of commodities. Okay, so whenever the price is increased, so on the basis of increasing the price, so the fixed income group will be reduced their amount of purchasing commodity. Okay, next, entrepreneurs. So in the inflation time, the entrepreneurs will get more profit. So not only the entrepreneurs, even the producers and the wholesaler, retailer and all the channel of distributors, everything, everybody will be get the more profit in the name of inflations, because we know on the basis of the demand only we have to increasing the supply of commodities. Okay, but if you ask when the producers are increasing the supply of commodities, mean so whenever the prices of commodity is increased, that time only he will increasing the supply, even if there is no demand or less demand, so the producers will increasing their supply, because whenever the prices are increased, so he can able to increase, able to earning more profit, right? Next, investors. The investor who generally invest in fixed interest yielding bonds and securities have much to loss during inflations. Okay, but in the inflation times, the persons who all invest on the bonds and securities, they will get many loss, because on the basis of the demand of the commodity, the bonds and securities will not increase. Okay, but in the same time, so the investors who generally invest in the shares, they will get the profit. because on the value of the commodities only, the share value will be increased. For example, if the prices of gold is increasing every week or every month, on the basis of increasing the gold rate, so the value of shares on gold also will be increased. Okay, so normally the investors who generally invest in the shares, they will get profit. Okay, so here, so the debtors and the creditors, this debtor will be get loss and the creditors will be as a gain as in the time of inflation. Next is fixed income groups. Fixed income group always will be fail to purchasing power in the time of inflation and they will face the worst hit during the inflation. Next, entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs in the sense, so all the producers and the sellers and the channel of distributors and the entrepreneurs will then have the more profit because of the high price of commodities. Next, investors. The investors invested on the bonds and debentures, they will get loss. And the investor who generally invest in the shares, they will get profit. Okay, students. Next, measures to control inflation. So we have studied, so the many problems are there in the time of inflation. Then we must control the inflation situation. The governments are have to taking the more effort to controlling the inflation. Okay, so what are the measures are undertaken by the government? Mean, so the three type of measures are broadly they will create. First one is monetary measures, next fiscal measures and other measures. Other measures means, so what are the measures are there, what are the reasons are there, so what are the remedies are there to controlling the inflation, everything also called as other measures. So monetary measures, the monetary measures mean, so the money, on the basis of money, how the inflation is increased, is finding out and they will resolve the supply of money. Okay, by reducing the supply of money, if we can control the inflation, that is called monetary measures. So in this monetary measures, all the monetary measures are adopted by the Reserve Bank of India, central bank of the nations, but in our nations the central bank is Reserve Bank of India. Okay, so for controlling the inflation situations, the Reserve Bank of India only have to take more effort. Okay, so on the one of the effect to controlling the inflation is increase in bank rate. So what is the meaning of bank rate? So the bank rate is the rate charged by the central bank for lending funds to the commercial banks. Okay, so under the Reserve Bank of India, many commercial banks are existing in our nations. This commercial bank only have to rendering the money to all the entrepreneurs and the public also. Okay, so for the purpose of providing the financial help, so the commercial bank will be fixing some amount of the rate of interest. Okay, so how much amount of interest is imposed by the commercial bank is guided by the Reserve Bank of India. Okay, but in the time of inflation, the Reserve Bank of India will be guided to the commercial banks to increase in the bank rate. And not only that, the Reserve Bank of India also will be provided the amount to the commercial bank on the base of some ratio of rate. So that time, in the time of inflation, the Reserve Bank of India also will be increased the rate of interest for the rendering money to the commercial banks. So the bank rate influence lending of commercial bank. Bank rate influence the lending rate of commercial banks, because on the basis of the rate of interest only, so the commercial bank also will be borrow the money from the Reserve Bank. On the basis of borrowed amount of borrowed money only, so the commercial bank will be rendering to the other entrepreneurs and publics. Okay, but when the Reserve Bank of India increasing the rate of interest to the commercial bank, so the commercial bank also will be increasing the rate of interest for the entrepreneurs and public. Okay, now when the rate of interest is higher, the entrepreneurs and the public also will not have the interest to borrow the money from the commercial bank. Okay, then automatically, so the amount of supply of money will come to one control. Next, sale of government securities in the open market. Sale of government securities in the open market. So the government always will be selling the debentures and bonds and securities to the public. Okay, so when the time of inflation, so the government will be selling their bonds and securities. Okay, so when the governments are selling the securities to the public, so the public also will be purchasing the securities. And how much amount of the money is held by the public, it will come to the government hand. Okay, so the government also will not supply the same money to the economy. Okay, so how much of the money is purchased or got from the public, so it will be saved in their locker. Next, cash reserve ratio. Cash reserve ratio. So cash reserve ratio is a specified minimum part of the total deposit of customer. So which commercial banks have to hold as a reserve either in cash or deposit with the central bank. Okay, so the every commercial bank have to deposit some amount of the total deposit of customer to the Reserve Bank of India. Okay, so every commercial bank must be provide or submit or hold some amount of the money in the form of reserve. Okay, for example, if the total deposit is 100 crores in one of the commercial bank mean, so the 30 crores or 20 crores must be provided to the Reserve Bank of India. Okay, but in the time of inflation, the Reserve Bank of India will be increased the amount of reserve ratio. Okay, normally if any of the commercial banks are having the reserve amount as a 20 crores means in the time of inflation, so the commercial bank have to increase the amount from 20 to 30 or 35, 40. So on the basis of the guidelines of Reserve Bank of India. Okay, so normally the Reserve Bank of India will be increased the reserve ratio, has reserve ratio. Okay, so when they are increasing the reserve ratio, the commercial bank have to keep the amount as higher. So in that time, so the remaining money only will be used to providing the or rendering the money to the entrepreneurs or the public. Okay, so automatically the supply and the having money from the entrepreneurs will come to the control. Next, consumer credit control. Consumer credit control mean, so what are the credit facilities is provided by the commercial banks, everything will stopped in the time of inflation. Okay, so the persons also will not having the purchasing power and will not having the interest to purchasing the commodities. Next, higher repo rate and the reverse repo rate. Okay, so repo rate means the Reserve Bank of India will be provided the amount to the commercial bank. Okay, so in the basis of some rate of interest. Okay, when they are providing the money for to the commercial bank, it will be increasing the high rate of interest. Next, fiscal measures. Some of the fiscal measures also will be undertaken by the government to controlling the inflation situations. Okay, so in these fiscal measures, first one is reduction of government expenditures. So the government will be reducing some amount to making the government expenditures. Okay, because of that, so all the persons also have to pay more amount. Next, public borrowing. Public borrowing also is the one of the rendering facilities provided by the commercial bank. Okay, normally, so what are the loan facilities is provided by the commercial bank will be stopped. Next, enhancing taxation. Enhancing taxation means, so type of the different type of the tax will be imposed, or some of the high amount of tax will be imposed by the government for the purpose of reducing the inflations. Okay students, next we will study about the basis of trade cycle. This is also we have studied in the first lesson itself to explaining some other concept. Okay, so a trade cycle refers to a oscillations and aggregate economic activity, particularly an employment, output, income, etc. Okay, so one of the macroeconomic aspect of unemployment, income, employment. So the basis of trade cycle also is one of the exposed criteria. So it is due to the inherent contraction and expansion of the elements which energize the economic activities of the nations. The fluctuations are periodical, differing in intensity and changing its coverage. So in this basis of trade cycle, the five bases are there. So all the economy also must be facing these all bases of trade cycle. So first one of the bases is boom or prosperity. Boom or prosperity. So the full employment and the movement of the economy beyond full employment is characterized on the boom period. Boom period means, so here see, so one of the economy, so one of the economy will be in the boom level. Boom level means, so the, in this boom level, so there is more employment opportunity and there is more national income and there is absence of the inflations and all the factor of productions will get the job and all the resources will be in fully employed. Okay, so all the factories and the firms and the purchasing power of the people, everything will be in higher level. Okay, so during this period there is hectic activity in the economy, so money wages also will be increased and the profit increased and industry also will be increased and the purchasing power of money will be in higher and the productivity of the all factor of productions will be in highest and the demand for bank credit increased and there is all round optimization. Okay, the demand for the bank credit means, so the bank also will be provided more amount to the required entrepreneurs and the public. Okay, so everybody will be started the new industries, new type of industries, and the public also will be in high purchasing power of commodities. Next, recession. So the turning point from the boom condition is called recession. Okay, because from the boom level, so the economy will fall down to depression. Okay, so after having the boom situations, every economy or every entrepreneur also will have lost their interest to producing, or the people also will get the low interest to go to the job, and because of many reasons, so the economy will fall down slowly. That situation is called recession period. Okay, so this happens at a higher rate than what was earlier. So generally the failure of the company or bank bust the boom and brings a basis of recession. Okay, normally if any of the company is in top level or the boom level, so definitely it will be face some of the losses. Okay, and the bank rate also will be increased sometime on the basis of the demand for the supply of money. Okay, and the people also will get some of the losses or some of the reduced the losses of the interest to going to the work. Okay, so on the basis of this many reasons, so the economy will fail from the boom level and it will be fell down to the depression area. Next, investment are drastically reduced because already we have made the more capital or more investment to start any of the industries, and throughout the world the industries and the supply of commodities will be very higher. Okay, so the supply of commodities may be very higher than the demand for the commodity. Okay, then automatically all the produced commodities will be in becoming a stock. So there is panic in the stock market and business activities show signs of dullness. Okay, so all the value of the shares will be reduced and the shareholders also will get some of the losses, and there is no profit from the share markets. Next, the liquidity preference of the people also will be rises and money market becomes tight. So people always will have the interest to having the more money in the liquidity form for the purpose of consuming more commodities. Okay, so no people will deposit in the bank. Next, because of that, the bank also will not be able to providing the money to the entrepreneurs. Then entrepreneurs will not continue their production activities. Okay, so the economy will fall down from the boom level to depression base. Next, depression. During depression, the level of economic activity becomes extremely low. Firms or all the industries incur losses, and the closure of business becomes a common feature. And the ultimate result is unemployment. Okay, so because of no production and because of no new industries, so the unemployment problem will be arrested in our economy. And interest prices, profits and wages are will be reduced or will be in low. Because if there is no production, so the producers will not be able to increase the wage and will not be able to providing the wage for their labor. Then automatically, so the low level will be decreased, and because of that, the unemployment problem will be arise. The agricultural class and the wage earners would be worst hit because there is no supply of commodity, there is no demand for the commodities in our nations, and because of that the people also will not able to purchasing the different type of commodities. Because of that, the agricultural peoples and the wage daily wage and peoples also will be in poverty situations. Okay, so and the banking institutions will be reluctant to advance loans to businessmen. Okay, so the business and the bank also will not provide any of the advance payment to the producers and the entrepreneurs. Okay, so because of that, so the entrepreneurs also will be stopped their production activities and they are not able to start and continue their business plans. Okay, so any person fell down in the deeps could not come out from the without others help. Okay, even if any of the persons are once fell down in the poverty situations in the time of depression, so without help of others they can't get up. So similarly, an economy fell down in tough could not come. So out from this without external help. So all the business activities, all the entrepreneurs, all the producers will be in very worst situations. So there is no production, there is no employment, there is no wage earners, there is no money supply, there is no demand for the commodities, and the people also will not having their purchasing power. Okay, so many of the problem will be there in our economy in the time of depression. Next, recovery. Okay, then from the period of the depression or the depression field, how the economy will recover. So after a period of depression, so the recovery base will be arising. So this is the turning point from depression to revival towards upswing. So it begins with the revival of demand for capital goods. So the demand for the capital goods, the production will be increased, and the demand also will be increased in our society. And autonomous investment boost the activity. Autonomous investment mean, so normally without having the interest, So the investment level will be increased. Next, the demand slowly picks up, and in the due course, the activity is directed towards the upswing. So normally, if the bank also will be increasing the money supply, and the bank also will be expand their providing capacity to the entrepreneurs and the public. So because of that, so the producers and the entrepreneur will be started any of the new industries, and the public also will be have some opportunity to purchasing the power, purchasing the commodity. And because of that, so the demand for the commodities may be increased. So the recovery may be initiated by innovation or investment by or by the government expenditures. Okay, so the money supply, because of increasing the money supply, so the, all the entrepreneurs will make the more investment on their productions. And in the same time, so the public also will have the chance to increasing their purchasing power of commodities. Okay, because of that, so again, so the economy will be recovered from the depression base. Okay, so all the economy must be facing these all bases of trade cycles. Okay, even the capitalistic nations or the socialistic nations or all the economy also must be facing these all the bases. Okay, first suppose if one of the nations are being in depression base, so it will taking the more effort to recovering from the depressions. Okay, so the money supply will be increased, and the bank also providing the more credit facilities, and the entrepreneurs will make the more investment to any of the new industries. Okay, because of this more effort, so the economy will be recovered from the basis of depressions. Okay, so that is the recovery field. And after recovery field, everything will be in boost. Okay, because of that, so the employment problem will be removed, and the full employment situation will be erased, and the wage earner also will be getting the more wage, and the producers also will be produced more commodities, and the purchasing power of the commodity of people also will be in higher, and so everything will be in prosperity. Okay, so the economy will be in boom. Okay, after that it will be fell down beyond one level. That period is called as a recession period. Okay student, so if you have any doubt in these basis of trade cycles and the measures to control inflation, please ask me. And study your study portions also, just to take the basis of trade cycle. The four basis of their boom or prosperity or recession or depression, next recovery. Okay, thank you.